In this video, I'm going to show you how anyone in your entire organization can get the reports they want in one single click using Alteryx Server. Let's get into it. Now, the issue is that we've had our clients have reporting solutions internally by having John in the corner. Hey, John, how you doing? Yeah, good, mate. He's got a reporting responsibility. He has to put together these two different spreadsheets every week, every month. And I, as a decision maker in my organization, have to ask John to create that report for me. You know, hey, John, can you do that sales report? No worries, Ben. I can do that for you in no time. Take me about 3 days to do that for you. Okay, right, 3 days, okay. I'll crack on with the rest of my work, do what I need to do. Hey, John, it's been a few days now. Have you got my sales report? Yeah, here you go, here it is. Got it open, and I'm looking through it. God, this is not what I wanted. That's not the right field. This doesn't reconcile. John, what's going on, mate? It's, oh, God. Anyway, what we've done in our transformation is we've taken John and we've helped him by automating his work. He's done it himself, right? We're not replacing John. He's done it himself in Alteryx Designer, right? That's level number one. If you want to learn more about Alteryx Designer, we've got a video specifically on that subject and tell you in detail what it's all about. Hey, you want to try Alteryx Designer? It's in the link in the description of this video. 30-day free trial. It's yours if you want it. But what we've done is we've got those reports of John. We've enabled him. We've empowered him to create these reports in Alteryx Designer. So now that we've got an Alteryx Designer, me as a decision maker or a business owner, I still have to go, John, hey, John, can you run that report for me? No worries. It's in Alteryx now, super simple. Click on to play, he gives me the report and he sends it over to me. All right, now we want to take it even further. We want to level up even further. We want to go to the Alteryx Server, right? The Alteryx Server is our way of taking what John has created and developed and deploying it onto a server environment. Now, why that's very special is because me, as a decision maker, as a stakeholder in my organization, I want to have access to all of my data across my business at my fingertips. Now, with Alteryx Designer, I have to ask John, Alteryx Server, I can log onto the server, I can see all of the reports that I've been permissioned access to, and I can run them at my leisure. From the CFO to the intern, anyone within the organization, of course, if they've got the permissions to run the report, that's important. But the point is, it's simple enough that anyone can do it. I'm not a techie user as a business owner, as a stakeholder in my business. I just want the data so I can make informed, data-driven decisions in my organization. And that is the benefit that Alteryx Server is going to provide for you. So let's cast my mind, and I'm going to be John right now, okay? I'm the Alteryx user. I'm not Ben anymore for the time being. I'm going to be John, the Alteryx user within this organization that I just described a moment ago. Now, I want to go ahead and create the report for decision makers in my business. Let's have a look at how I can do that from within Alteryx Designer and then boot it up to Alteryx Server. So here I am in Alteryx Designer. You can see that on your screen right now. If you're familiar with the product, this is going to look very simple for you indeed, right? This is a nice workflow. Give it a run. Here we go. Got some customer information coming in at the bottom. Have a look at that. Here's our customers. Here's some transactions those customers are making. And all I'm doing, nice simple concept, is I'm joining these two data sets together so I can say which customers have spent how much. And as a decision maker, I can then see who are my most influential customers within my organization. Great, okay. So now I want to deploy this to make it self-service on the Alteryx Server. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to File, Save As, Alteryx Server, and I've now got it connected to our own Alteryx Server instance. So a variety of different configuration options that I could choose from, but you know what, I'm just gonna go for save. Here we go, it's now saved, it's up in the gallery. Once it's up in the gallery, as it's called, in Alteryx Server, I can then share that with as many people as I want. Let's take a look in the server, shall we? This is the Alteryx Server itself. Wow, look at this. So I can see that this is the workflow that I've just deployed as John and shared to the business owners or the decision makers in the organization. So now they don't have to chat to me. I build and manage the solution as an Alteryx Designer, of course I do, but they are now self-service. They come into an interface like this. Okay, here's a list of all of my different workflows that I've been permissioned access to. Okay, yeah, I want to go on the app validation one, for example. Let's give it a click here. I'm going to go into the run button. Here we go, and I'm just prompted for a few different questions, okay? So you as a designer user in Alteryx, you can customize what parameters are gonna be available for whoever's self-serving themselves with the reports. For this particular sales report, I wanna say, hey, you know what, I'm interested in client C. I'm gonna go for that one there. And I wanna see the report from April 2023. Great, okay, so I've defined the parameters of the report that I want. After that, the only thing left for me to do is to click on to run. Here we go. It's going to run on the Alteryx server. That process is now completed successfully. Here we go. I can download. Here we go. I'm going to choose a XLSX, XL format. Download that now. Pop it open. And this is what's been created. Again, it might seem a little bit crude. Of course, we can fine tune this. We can put lovely colors, all that sort of stuff. But I'm just proving the concept for you here today. All I had to do is that business owner who wanted to get the reporting, I log on to the Alteryx gallery. Here's my list, and I go ahead and select what I want, put in my parameters, click on to run, and I get this data. Look at this data I've got from my systems, directly from my systems, and it's always gonna be exactly the same thing every single time. Therefore, I can have all of that data at my fingertips and really start to leverage my business by making it fully data-driven. Now, this is just step number two of a four-step journey on becoming truly data-driven. Now, if you want to learn about all four of those steps and what you can do to move along that journey, click on this video right here. There you go. And you can see the four distinct steps and what you need to do to move along to become truly data-driven.